she kind of reminds me of grandma, but she's even more not liberal, but more, she likes more of today's music, and how grandma couldn't stand it.
Yeah.
She's like 72. She's so sweet.
Before we start, do you want to say how you found the recipe? And like when
started? Wait a minute. Let me see if I might make a mess, but... I would've known, but oh well, this is just me being me. So I'm gonna say how I found it, where you understand.
Right there is good.
Say when.
No, you're good. I've been recording.
Oh.
But I edit it, okay. so I can cut out parts and whatever. I just get the whole thing and I get all the important parts.
So I found this recipe for these peanut butter filled cookies about 30 years ago in the National Enquirer, and I cut it out and saved it all these years, and now it's our tradition to make it every year, and we're about to start.
What year was it, you think, and how old was I? And you
well,
did it
when I found the recipe, I was 24 when I first got married to your dad.
Oh, so I wasn't even, nobody was born yet?
Yeah, I found it and I started making them when I was with your dad.
Oh, so you made it before we were born, see, I didn't even know that.
So I've been making them every year since then. And thank you for perfecting the recipe, because they were so tedious, I was getting ready to look for another recipe. But you insisted on making these cookies, and I'm glad you did, because I love making them, and it's just a part of Christmas tradition.
I would say that because of my 4 years of cooking experience, that I was able to tweak some things and make it way easier to do. Just like simple things that made them way less tedious, but are not nearly as difficult to do anymore.
Okay, we're about to begin. And we do the peanut butter filling over here. Or which one you do?
Yeah, we do the chocolate and
this one?
Yeah, and the mixing bowl, because it requires us to beat the eggs and stuff. And then we do the dry ingredients in that big bowl.
Okay, so what temperature do I set the oven at?
I believe it's 350.
75?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and since I took the picture on my phone, it makes it way better. Because instead of digging it out, and also the paper's really old, because that's the very first time you cut it out, right? That piece of paper.
Oh, you got it.
Yeah.
That's from National Enquirer.
Yeah, I took that picture because I didn't know how long that paper would last. Yeah. Obviously, it's not gonna last forever, but I can airdrop it to you if you want. Okay. There's two bags up top. They're the Kroger ones.
Best Buy, October 2022.
I mean, I did use that one for something. I don't remember what.
It feels soft.
Yeah, then use it. It's
and
fine.
It says October 22nd, 2022.
Trust me, when it's all in there, you're not going to notice a difference anyways. All right,
so what did you say, a cup and a half of flour?
Yeah, 1.5 cups of flour.
I forgot to get my apron out. Are you wearing an apron?
I don't have to. Hey, you know, this is actually for liquid.
Oh, so what am I supposed to use?
These are for dry.
Oh.
And these is for liquid. It'll come out to be different amounts.
Okay.
So like 1.5 in this will not be 1.5 in these.
Okay, so those are dry?
Yeah, because that might be another reason why sometimes they turn out a little drier or more moist.
Okay. So I should have washed this, but...
I use that one too, but it doesn't really matter.
Okay, so let's...
What I do, I'll just do 3 of these.
Okay.
Because it's 1.5.
I'm gonna watch the pro. I'm not mad. Oh, they actually have a thing on there that you can grab up and out, but I have a silver thing for that somewhere. But it came with one.
Yeah, I know. I don't know. I'm having that way.
Okay, show me your trick. Show me your trick. I'll let you do it. I'm gonna watch you, then I'll learn. Okay. I've been doing it the hard way all these years.
You make it way harder on yourself.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, just go ahead.
I always say, see, you might actually, this might be a good representation of what I was saying.
I could have probably showed more.
You already have it all measured out in there.
Yeah. It's pretty close.
It is close, but that could be the difference between dry. Because, you know, sometimes when I'm making my own stuff, I need like that much more to make it not too gooey. So you just never know.
Cocoa?
Half a cup of unsweetened cocoa. So right here is half a cup.
Okay, I thought we had some open up here.
there's two out
there. Can you reach them, please? Somebody make us some brownies. I'm going to use that, too. Okay, so how much?
Half a cup, one of these. I just sleep in there, I don't even care.
Well, it's got flour on it, though.
I don't think it's gonna make a difference.
That's unusual.
Yeah, I've never seen that.
Usually they leave you a little space. They pack it in there. And how much, a half teaspoon?
Yeah, half teaspoon. So you know there's a dry and liquid side of that, right?
Yeah, that's one's dry?
That's the dry side. The circle is the dry side.
Because you figure you would pour and it would make it. So
yeah, that's a good way to remember it. But
it would be pouring, okay.
Yeah, and that's another way you can kind of tell too, is the liquid is usually, I think, slightly bigger for volume reasons.
Okay. So a half teaspoon?
Yeah, half a teaspoon.
Okay, got it.
And then that one you just blend with a fork.
It's easier to mix it with
the
mixer.
Yeah, but remember we pour that into this. Remember we make the wet one in there and then we add the dry into it.
Oh.
Cause that,
pour it over here?
Yeah, so when you're done with that, just pour it in there. You can just pour it into here.
Oh, now you don't want me to dip it.
Well, that's different because that's different.
Ooh. Well, we're expected to make a mess.
Here, pour it back in.
You just make too much sense. It's a half cup.
And then now, half cup of firmly packed brown sugar.
What
I do is I stick it in here and I break it up like this.
I'm gonna learn. I'm gonna make another batch of these today with Nikki, so.
Yeah, see?
Okay. Okay.
It ends up getting melted.
Once we put it on defrost instead of cooked. Me and John, because this was my idea, I wanna make gingerbread men. So we're gonna look up a recipe and make them next Thursday.
Gingerbread men?
Yeah. I've always wanted to make them, never did. Something fun.
Yeah, I got these ones. They're like half sticks.
Oh.
Still the same amount. That's the only one they had.
Oh, when you got them for me?
Yeah. But it's still two equals one. They're just half sticks.
Okay, so what are we doing?
We're frosting them. I wrap them, but I keep it underneath.
I just keep it on the bottom part, okay.
Yeah, just in case.
But you're teaching me. I love it. And actually, John is a really good cook. He made Thanksgiving dinner by himself. He's a really good cook. Which works out for me, because you know me, I don't cook. Okay, so defrost. We don't have a note how long to defrost, right?
20 seconds. But it asks for a wait, so I just hit one. Just hit one.
Right, and then we'll just watch it.
It just hits start, because it's going to automatically go.
Like 20 seconds or so?
Yeah, just check it after 10 though, because it'll melt in a blink of an eye.
Even on defrost?
This what happened to me. I waited 5 extra seconds and then it just got destroyed.
What did it start at? 40.
Oh,
it says
10.
No, it's still hard.
Maybe 5 more seconds. Or 5 or 10.
I said 10, it's really hard.
There, see that
back mark?
See it?
What the?
That's what I was saying.
I'm gonna have defrost, so they're, are they soft enough to?
They should, yeah, that's fine.
Oh, I don't want your phone to fall. Oh, I know what I'll do, Chucky. Get my phone stand. Here we go. Here, I got my phone stand. Now what? I don't know what you're doing.
Now.
Oh, in here.
Yeah. Which is a quarter cup, which if I do the math,
How do you do my grams?
Yeah, 64. Yeah. So it'll be 64 grams of peanut butter. Yeah, I think you put it all over here, didn't you?
Oh, okay.
How do you measure it?
Yeah, you just Google it?
Yeah, I already did the math.
But I want to know for when I do it.
Okay, look. This is how you do it.
So we need how much?
You can just write this down then, because right. If you pull out your phone, you're doing it, trying to do all the math. But see how it says 2 tablespoons is 32 grams?
Yeah.
Well, 16 tablespoons is in 1 cup. So that means divided by 4, you get 4 tablespoons per quarter cup, which is what we need for this one. So that's right there, right? We need 4 tablespoons, which is that times 2, so that's 64 grams.
Okay. So this is way less messy.
This is how I did the math on Google. You just type in how many tablespoons in a cup. See, that says 0.25, that's a quarter. So if I did 16, it comes out to be 1 whole cup. And we're going to need 3 quarters cup.
We need 3 quarters cup of peanut butter?
For the peanut butter filling. So if I type in 0.75 up here, that means it's 12. So divide
that's telling you how many grams?
No, that's telling you how many tablespoons. Oh. It's all conversions. That's why I said to make it less complicated. I can just write down the amount of grams you need for when you do it.
Alright. So
we need 4. So we need 64 grams of peanut butter for in here.
This is gonna make it way less messy. We don't have to worry about cleaning the thing or nothing. That was the most messy part.
I can let you do that part if you want.
What, this part?
Yeah.
So how many? 64, you said?
Yeah. So you just you can use whatever you want. Probably that knife that we already
have
out.
That's what I'm thinking. So 64.
Yeah, just take it out so it says negative 64.
Right. That's what I've been doing with my snack. I'm probably not going to get it all in one chunk, right?
No, I wouldn't expect to. You're good. Just throw it in here.
64.
Yeah, you're good. Throw it in here.
Oh, just keep it. Okay. Mine's a lot sharper than mine.
And I swear, these cookies come out better when we use the natural peanut butter, because it's not like, I don't know, maybe it has something to do with not having all the added hydrogenated fats and stuff to keep it a solid at room temperature, so it blends easier, I think.
Right, it's really creamy too. Almost there. 62.
Yeah. It's okay if you're off by 1 or 2 grams. It's not going to make a big deal.
Oh, now it says 61.
That'll be fine. You can put it in there.
Okay. Oh, wow. This is way easier. I love it.
Yeah, see, now you don't have all that stuff to clean now. You
exactly.
Know what I'm.
I love it. It's amazing. Genius. And I got to scale it down.
If you look at the ingredients on here too, it literally just says peanuts, sugar, and salt.
Molasses. Mm. Okay, so now what?
We blend that up with the blender.
Does any eggs or vanilla go in it?
After we blend this first.
We have to blend this first with the mixer?
Yeah.
You can tell that it's more creamy than the...
It is.
Zip or Skippy.
That's because it's natural, that's why. You know they put stuff in Zip and Skippy to make it a solid at room temperature, right?
Oh, and this one's just all natural.
Right.
So it's beat, right?
And when you put the egg in it, it gets way fluffier.
Imprint date on that cutout
I have. You know
how
sometimes like
copyright the small print has a date?
Yeah.
I wonder what's
said
on it.
It
would have been around like 91.
The eggs I bought for you, I'm just gonna write it on Sharpie. Put K on it.
Okay. Okay, so what?
One egg. I'll do it one-handed.
Behind his back, blindfolded.
See if I can do it. I usually can do it pretty easily. There we go.
I need a pro.
There.
Okay, so I'm going to take some of this stuff to John's to make breakfast.
I don't know if that's, I don't know what the date is or anything. It's got almost nothing in it.
Did you?
Yeah.
So,
1 teaspoon.
1 teaspoon.
See how much more fluffy that is? Remember when you first started beating it and it was like kind of almost crumbly? And
yeah.
Now it's almost like a paste.
Yeah, I think it didn't do it long enough.
And I don't know if you know this, but with some recipes, people, would they use egg whites and they use a blender and they whip it and it literally turns into like a whipped cream.
Oh yeah.
So like when you add the egg and then you blend it even more, it's gonna get extremely fluffy.
This is good to 2024, September.
Plus, I don't even think it's open.
Right.
Is it? Yeah, it's been open. It's all good. Again, it's going to be like 3 times as fluffy.
So 1 teaspoon.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because that egg is going to be the difference as well.
Okay. My hand's going to fall off. Okay, now what?
You got to add in the dries very slowly. I usually use a glove with my hand.
Oh.
Which actually...
I saw that one box was empty.
Yeah, that's empty. But I think from last time when I did it, it was really tough to do at first. So what I think I want to do is try it with a wooden spoon at first and then move to a glove if I need to.
Oh, good. I was getting ready. Remember I told that when you're let's make something else. You're like, no, this is our tradition.
I can already tell you this is 100 times better than using a glove at first. I think if you use your hands, it's better when the dough is already formed.
I get it.
And it's not like creamy like a peanut butter. Because if you try to use your hands in peanut butter, you know how that works.
And it just helps mold it. I get it. Let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss. Are there clothes on here? I'll take them out.
I don't think so.
I thought I had 2 boxes already given you.
I mean, I don't know.
I don't care if you did.
I mean, I use them every time I make chicken, but I don't recall seeing a second box.
Would a sandwich bag work? You put a sandwich bag on your hand? Oh wait, I found some. I knew it. I got a hold of it. Oh, wow. Okay. This was out of the box, should I probably throw it away? I'm gonna throw it out. I bought these cooling racks from Pampered Chef.
That?
It's a baking company. You can buy all kinds of stuff with it from there. It's kind of expensive. Yeah. It's a really, really good brand, a good company. Pampered Chef. I'm probably not heard of it. And I've actually seen these similar ones in the other stores, but it's like a little bit more expensive. But they have all kinds of baking stuff. Measuring spoon, you name it, cutting boards, measuring cups. So we're done with this block and let's do the big peanut butter balls in here. Did you use that cookie thing?
Yeah.
I bought it a couple years ago, so I might as well. The baking sheets. Those baking sheets are amazing. They're not even rusty or nothing.
So just so you know, if it becomes like too much of like a peanut butter consistency, where you can't, where it's not like a dough because it's too wet, then just throw like a teaspoon of flour in at a time.
Okay. So I guess it's slightly.
Yeah. See, like that already makes a huge difference. That's because
I think they could have been caused by slightly over mixing, but I wouldn't worry about it.
Right.
I would just wait till you get to this point and then add in like a teaspoon of flour at a time. Because now it's like, see, now it's actually like a dough.
Okay.
We get like a half more.
Do we even use regular sugar?
We did. I think you put it away.
Okay, I'm gonna come in here and do that part.
Alright, I just grabbed the ginormous peanut butter ball. Press that red button right there.
This one?
Yeah. Yeah, you can hold the front of it.
Times for 16, 18, 20, 20, 25 cookies.
I mean, mathematically speaking, if you made each peanut butter ball like an eighth of an inch bigger on every single one, you'd wind up with probably like five less. You know what I'm saying?
Just do them a little bit bigger. They're amazing. Taking pictures or?
No, it's a video.
Oh, okay.
It's just my lens. It has a low aperture. So when I get close to things and focus on them, the depth of field is really high. So it makes it look super high quality and the background's really blurry.
I wanna see the video when you're done with it.
See, like if I go like that, or actually, let me show you right here. You can see it.
Do you usually smooth the edges, or do you care?
I don't care. You see this? How it looks?
Yeah.
It's all like, those are all blurry, that's really clear. That's why I get close to things. It just makes it look really cinematic.
I gotta fix the sugar.
I told you when I do it, I just don't flatten them. Just purely because I like, it's more of like a cake, consistent like a brownie.
I like doing this, because I like to put frosting on them.
That's what I mean, but you can do either or. It's a preference.
I'm trying them like